In this video, I'll demonstrate how to deploy Azure Compute Fleet, a fundamental component that enables the creation of a virtual machine fleet, combining standard and spot VM types via a single API call. I'll start by creating a compute fleet in the Azure portal. In the search bar, type Compute Fleet, and then select it. On the Compute Fleet page, select Create Compute Fleet. Start on the Basics tab. Under Project Details, select the Subscription and Resource Group. In Instance Details, type the name of the fleet. Also, choose the region, availability zones, and security type. Then, choose a marketplace image and select your CPU architecture. Next, configure the virtual machine types. As I mentioned earlier, you can include both standard and spot VM instances in your fleet. Then, move on to selecting your VM sizes. You can select up to 15 sizes, which enhances the diversity of SKUs in your fleet and enables quicker access to Azure resources. The next step is to configure the spot VMs. Set capacity preferences to maintain capacity. This ensures that if a spot VM is evicted due to pricing or capacity issues, the fleet will automatically replace the evicted VM with an alternate VM size to maintain target capacity. You can also set your target capacity. Compute Fleet allows you to deploy up to 10,000 instances in a single request. Set the eviction policy next. Selecting Delete VMs removes the VM and all its resources. Selecting Deallocate VMs keeps the data, including the NICs, disk, and storage. Moving on to allocation strategy. Spot offers three different allocation strategies for different workload requirements. I recommend selecting optimized price and capacity to balance costs with high availability. Next, you can set the hourly price for Spot to give you price protection in case Spot prices increase during your fleet runtime. After that, configure the standard capacity of the fleet. Just specify the target capacity, and if you would like to specify the minimum starting capacity, you can do that too. And finally, configure the administrator account. So now, I'll go to the networking tab by selecting Next. For my demo, I've already filled in this information. And with that, I'm ready to create the compute fleet. It can really be that simple. Just two tabs on the Create a Compute Fleet page. We tried to make it as easy as possible to launch multiple instances via a single API call. Just select Review and Create to start the validation process. Once the validation successfully passes, I can create the deployment by selecting Create to submit it. And now, deployment is underway. You see the fleet resources getting created and the VMs provisioned. This will take a few minutes. And now that deployment is complete and successful, I can go on to the Manage Experience page by selecting Go to Resource. Fleet level information is here, like the resource group, the successful provisioning status, and the subscription ID used to provision the resources. We also have the compute fleet details, which includes the region, the target capacity for standard VMs, the target capacity for spot VMs, and the disk level details, and the different VM sizes that were included as part of building this fleet. Now, move on to settings, under which are instances, capacity, and sizes. These offer more granular information about the VMs and their capacity. Select Instances to see all the VMs provisioned and their statuses. In this case, they're all running and successfully provisioned. It also shows whether the VMs are standard or spot, and the VM sizes used to meet the target capacity. You can always change target capacity at any time. For example, if you have excess capacity, delete as many VMs as necessary. Select individual VMs, standard and spot, and delete them. That's it for my demo. If you have workloads that are fault tolerant and can handle interruptions, Compute Fleet offers the best savings on cost while optimizing for capacity to complete your workload.